we must all take a stand as a country and say wrong is wrong. No one has the right to kill or attack any other human being, especially those who choose our country as their homes and hope for economic recovery. So ourselves as broadcasters, regulators, and citizens, I urge all of you to strongly condemn the unwarranted attacks in the spirit of nation building and social cohesion. Dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, I consider it a very special honor to be invited to address this August gathering of experts and influencers in the realm of the digital communications. I have no doubt that you shared expertise and input. I had a session with our guests. And then out of that, I'm regretting that I was unable to form part of your earlier discussions. There were some pressing agenda matters that we had to attend this cabinet. And then I'd like again to apologize for that, because my take initially was that I was going to sit for the whole 3 days in this conference. But I was being updated on a daily basis on the presentations that we were making. There was somebody who was updating me. And then I could see there were insightful deliberations that took place in our absence. But you must all know that we're with you in spirit. I must say the digital migration process is very close to my heart. And I'm confident that our country is ready to boldly step into digital migration realm. Our journey in this regard is immensely shaped by this type of engagements. I was telling the international delegation, to even my colleagues, to say we shouldn't reduce this conference to a talk shop. Out of this conference, I think as a country we can develop some point plans, and then we can start to put everything in action. Also, Lynn, I think it's important that we start to form strategic partnership with all the of you, especially our international guests, because they are best practices that we can learn as a country. I'm also reliably informed that you shared your experiences with the members of my department, the entities that are responsible for the implementation of the DTT project. That includes the also colleagues from the other department, the telecoms and postal services, your Centec in particular. I'm also heartened that you all have shown a keen interest on the progress towards the implementation of the digital terrestrial television program in South Africa. Colleagues, I'm also happy to report to you that South Africa is well on track successfully implementing the digital migration program. We have established a digital television, terrestrial television project management office, which is hard at work behind scenes. The necessary police amendments have been successfully finalized and approved by Cabinet on the 4th of March 2015, and then we later subsequently gazetted it on the 18th of March 2015. We are planning to implement the project over an 18-month period, and we have put together a program to guide us in this regard. We have also completed the implementation plan. I'm informed the work to finalize the technical set-top box control specification is at an advanced stage. I believe that Centec, ICASA, and broadcasters have also shared their state of readiness with this conference. They are ready to travel with us on this historic journey. Centec has completed 84% geographic coverage, with the remaining 60% to be covered by satellite. All 178 transmitters are in place, and the digital terrestrial television head ends have also been configured. We have standards in place with DT SANS 862, DVB-2T, T2, as approved by the South African Bureau of Standards. The DTT regulations by ICASA also are ready. I believe the chairperson was here, he might have shared that with you. We continue to engage with all stakeholders in this process in order to encourage them to play their respective role in implementing the broadcasting digital migration. And as a country, we can proudly say that we are on track with the implementation of the digital terrestrial television program. Program director, our march towards a brave new digital frontier was never going to be without challenges. However, we are a country that is known for the ability to overcome the most intractable obstacles. In order to manage issues related to interference with neighboring state posts, switch on, we are working on a program to engage our neighbors with a view to conclude bilateral agreements. The ministers of our neighboring states are also aware of the need to engage with South Africa, and a harmonized effort is being executed. Closer to home, we are working with entities and stakeholders to enhance and expedite consumer awareness around digital migration. We have also embarked on a massive communication program to spread the word about digital migration. I have transferred the country recently and spoke to the people during the Zimbizo, which take a form of a community discussion. They have been on several broadcasters on community radios, and several articles have been published in the monthly state newspaper called Vukuzenzele, which has a circulation of 1.7 million hard copies. We have also not forgotten about the importance of taking our partners along with us every step of the journey. ICASA, SABC, Brand SA, ECIS, Film and Publication Board, and the MDDA were also invited in all our Izimbizo so that they too communicate their role on the rollout process. Ladies and gentlemen, it's often easier to trade the path that others have already followed. We are happy that the delegates shared with us the challenges that they faced in their own countries during the process of implementation. This knowledge and these shared experiences will enable us to better prepare ourselves during the rolling out of digital migration. Allow me to note some of the common challenges that we also shared with the panel earlier, which has been highlighted during this conference. They include insufficient consumer awareness, poor coordination with relevant stakeholders, bilateral with neighboring countries not sticking, signing of memorandum of understanding with neighboring countries, uncertainties about the achievement of target dates, lack of mitigating strategies should targets not be met, reliance by countries on information from the ITU website. Let me assure you that we have noted all of the above in confidence, and we can share with you that the department and the role players are taking these matters very seriously. They will form part of our risk register, as we believe forewarned is forearmed. Taking from the UK model, I believe it is a good model that will assist us towards the implementation of the program. I therefore expect my team to take these lessons on board. They, amongst others, include clearly defined processes, roles and responsibilities, central coordination and governance structures, identifying common goal, which is the viewers in this part, in particular, review and refine processes, e.g. communication, learning lessons for future programs, and key conclusion, namely a collaborative industry-led approach and produce benefits for viewers, broadcasters, and government. From Norway, we learned that the successful implementation of audio broadcasting, the following sixes are the obstacles to overcome. That means your coverage, cost, communication, content, collaboration, and commitment. In closing, programs will be developed with all of the above raised issues in mind. Our priority actions going forward will be to engage with the neighboring countries for spectrum harmonization. The bilaterals are going to be concluded before the deadline of 17 June 2015. On behalf of the people of South Africa, I wish to thank all of you with profound humility for your assistance.